Welcome to the Healthy Life. I hope you're all safe. In this brief video, I'll discuss hemorrhoids, often known as piles, which are a frequent, uncomfortable, and annoying condition. Disorder. According to certain sources, 60 to 70% of people will suffer from hemorrhoids. They've all done it at some point in their lives. Furthermore, it is estimated that one out of every 20 Americans suffers from symptomatic hemorrhoids. Hemorrhoids can afflict people of different ages, genders, and backgrounds. Races and ethnicities are becoming increasingly frequent as people become older, affecting more than half of the population. People over the age of 50. So, first and foremost, what exactly are hemorrhoids? Our rectum and anus, on the other hand, contain a plentiful supply of blood arteries. And, on occasion, due to certain circumstances, these veins swell and grow for a variety of causes that we shall go over later. Inside and outside the anus and rectum, swollen, bulging veins are known as varicose veins. Hemorrhoids are a type of hemorrhoids. They can be painful, inconvenient, and sometimes result in bleeding. Inside or outside the rectum, hemorrhoids can occur. The kind is determined by the location. Veins get enlarged. They can be internal, external, or prolapsed based on this information. Hemorrhoids. Swollen veins grow beneath the skin around the anus in external piles. External hemorrhoids are a type of hemorrhoid that itching and discomfort are possible side effects. They may bleed on occasion. They can fill up with blood at times. That, too, can clot. Although this is not harmful, it can cause a lot of pain and swelling. As well as discomfort, internal hemorrhoids are characterized by enlarged veins that develop on the inside of the rectum. The rectum is the part of your digestive system that links your stomach to your intestines, the large intestine or the colon to the anus. Internal hemorrhoids may bleed, although they are not dangerous. The majority of the time, they aren't painful. Internal and external hemorrhoids are also possible. They can prolapse outside of the anus, meaning they can expand and bulge. It's possible that a lump is forming in your anus, producing discomfort. As with the prior hemorrhoids, these hemorrhoids may bleed or hurt. So, who has a higher chance of getting hemorrhoids? Anyone, including teenagers, can develop symptomatic hemorrhoids. If you are overweight or obese, you may be at a higher risk. Hemorrhoids are also more likely to occur during pregnancy. Poor dietary habits, such as constipation, can be caused by a low-fiber, high-carbohydrate diet. This is a fairly common hemorrhoid risk factor. Lifting large objects, spending a lot of money, and so on are all bad habits. Spending a lot of time on the toilet and straining to pass bowel movements can also lead to constipation. To the formation of hemorrhoids. Let's discuss about the symptoms and indicators of hemorrhoids now. Unless internal hemorrhoids prolapse, they rarely cause pain and are rarely noticed. Many persons with internal hemorrhoids are unaware that they have them because they don't have any symptoms. Have signs and symptoms. If you have symptomatic internal hemorrhoids, though, you may see blood on the toilet paper, stools, and the toilet bowl. Rectal hemorrhage is indicated by these symptoms. External hemorrhoids can cause the following symptoms: itchy anal area, hard lumps around the anus that are painful, pain in the anal region, especially when it's swollen or painful. You take a seat, as well as rectal bleeding. Hemorrhoids that have prolapsed can be extremely painful. You might be able to feel them expanding from the outside. Anus. Hemorrhoids can be unpleasant and inconvenient, but they seldom cause significant complications. People with hemorrhoids are more likely to develop anemia. External hemorrhoids with blood clots. Infection. In the anal region, there are skin tags. How can you know if you have hemorrhoids? Your doctor can determine if you have hemorrhoids depending on your symptoms. Based on symptoms and a physical evaluation, some simple tests can also be carried out, including as your doctor will do a digital rectal examination by inserting a gloved, lubricated finger into the bowel. Feel your rectum for bulging veins. This aids in the diagnosis and testing of the location. The efficacy of the current treatment, endoscopy, is another procedure that can be performed. To observe the lining, your doctor uses an anoscope, which is essentially a lighted tube. Of the rectum and anus, advanced procedures include sigmoidoscopy and colonoscopy. Procedures including the use of a lit sigmoidoscope or colonoscope by your doctor. Tubes with a camera that let you to see what's going on inside the lower colon and rectum. These exams aren't unpleasant, but they are uncomfortable. Normally, they take place without anesthetic in a doctor's office or outpatient center. You may also return home. The same day they're crucial since these tests aid in the development of new products. Your doctor to rule out any serious issues that could be mistaken for hemorrhoids, such as cancer and inflammatory bowel disease. Bowel problems. What are my options for treating hemorrhoids at home? Hemorrhoids usually go away on their own. Treatment. Symptoms like as discomfort and bleeding might persist up to a week or even longer. Meanwhile, you can soothe symptoms and minimize pain by following these simple measures. Lidocaine or hydrocortisone-containing over-the-counter drugs can be applied to the affected area. The affected area, which aids in pain relief. Constipation can be avoided by drinking 2 to 3 liters of water per day. Increase your fiber intake as well. This is one of the most crucial things you can do. Consume more food. Fruits, vegetables, and whole grains are all good sources of fiber. This softens the stool and makes it bulkier. You can also acquire 20 to 30 grams of fiber per day by taking a fiber supplement. To begin, consider taking a psyllium husk fiber supplement. If psyllium makes you feel bloated or gassy, try taking a supplement with psyllium. Methylcellulose or wheat dextrin sitz baths are extremely beneficial for lowering blood pressure. The signs and symptoms of hemorrhoids in a sitz bath: the inflamed area is soaked in warm water for several minutes. 2 to 3 times a day, for 10 to 15 minutes. You can try this if you have chronic constipation. To soften the feces, take some laxatives. You can also take an over-the-counter pain reliever. Medicines such as acetaminophen, aspirin, or ibuprofen to alleviate pain caused by hemorrhoids. When you're working, don't sit for too long or push yourself too hard. You pass feces. When the desire strikes, go to the bathroom and don't hold it in. Procrastinate bowel movements. Use toilet paper scented with lotion or flushable toilet paper. After passing stools, use moist wipes to gently pat and clean your bottom. This will make you feel better. To your anal region and protect it from rubbing damage. Topical therapies such as over-the-counter hemorrhoid creams or suppositories can also be used. Hydrocortisone is present in this product. Additionally, numbing medications such as lignocaine gels may aid in the management of pain. The discomfort caused by hemorrhoids. If your symptoms worsen or begin to interfere with your everyday life, you should see a doctor. Or go to bed. If your symptoms don't improve after a few days, seek medical care. A week of treatments at home if your problem is still not fixed. Perhaps there may be some issues. It is possible to develop improved treatments to cure hemorrhoids, such as sclerotherapy, rubber band ligation, electrocoagulation, infrared coagulation. Surgical therapies that are used as a last resort include hemorrhoidectomy and hemorrhoid stapling are two procedures used to treat hemorrhoids. So, I hope this video was informative and you learned something new about this illness. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch and comment. Look forward to seeing you in the future video.